Hi, this is Ken Axe from RazorClamming.com. Today, we're going to talk about the third way to clam. Everybody knows about getting clams up on the sand, how to find shows, dig clams on the sand. Everybody also knows about how to get clams in the surf, and that's when you're either an inch or two underwater or even a foot underwater, and you're pounding underneath the water to get shows and then catch the clams. But there's a third way, and some days they're not showing up on the sand and they're not showing out in the surf. But some days in the water runoff of the tide, you can find little anomalies and that's a clam. And I've limited out many times when you can't see clams on the sand or in the surf by just watching for these little anomalies. Runoff, that's where the water gets to be about an eighth of an inch thick, and as the water comes down the sand, any anomaly you can see because the water breaks around it. And you can see right here, as the water is coming just off the sand, you got about a quarter inch of water there. You can see the ripples and such. And you stand here, and you may have to stand here for 5, maybe 10 minutes, and you just look for little anomalies in the sand. We're going to do that right now and see what we can come up with. But this is a great way to limit out. If they're not showing up there on the sand and they're not showing in the surf, I've limited out a lot, just looking for little anomalies in the sand, and you can face toward the beach looking for the anomalies, or you can turn around and watch the water run into the ocean. It doesn't matter, it's just when it's about a quarter to an eighth of an inch, or even when it starts plateauing off like it is now to where there's almost no water before the surf comes in, you can see anomalies. And the clams basically will stick their head up to eat or go to the bathroom. You can see them squirt, or if they just move around, you can find an anomaly. That's the third way to get clams. Ken Axe from RazorClamming.com.